Rudolph Roman of the Roman Show with Tom Lauder here, part of Major League Wrestling here in town in South Florida. Tom, thanks so much for your time, dude.
Hey, no problem. Glad to be here.
Well, Tom, I mean, you've been doing very phenomenal in pro wrestling, but you actually had the pro wrestling background before the MMA stuff.
Yeah. So here I am back doing professional wrestling, like as you mentioned, with Major League Wrestling, along with some other companies. I've been back at wrestling for about 18 months, almost 2 years now. But in between that time, of course, I was fighting the UFC. Previous to that, however, I did do professional wrestling. So I've always been in and out of the two worlds. My first fight was 2003. And then I did some professional wrestling work after that in between, about 2005, 2006. Went to the UFC, been there for 10 years, and now here I am back on this scene. So,
in fact, correct me if I'm wrong, you were part of the ROH at one time, right? You managed some guys there. You worked with the Young Bucks?
Well, yeah. I did a thing managing Kyle O'Reilly and Bobby Fish, the Red Dragon, as they won the tag titles against the Young Bucks. I also cornered them at some other events. It was something that was going to be promoted in the future, and then the UFC kind of came down on me and put the kibosh on it. But a lot of those same people that were there helping that get set up with me in Ring of Honor here in MLW as well. Big surprise. So.
Yeah, how crazy is that? Now we're seeing a lot of transition, and it seems to fit so well when you're a mixed martial artist and you make the transition to pro wrestling. We've seen the success that Ronda Rousey has made.
Yeah.
Matt Riddle's another guy you know very well. I mean, is it very easy to make that transition from MMA to wrestling compared to a wrestler to an MMA fighter?
I would say that the transition is definitely going to be easier coming from the MMA background into wrestling, as long as you have the right mindset. You know, a lot of guys come from a fighting background and think that martial arts and, they look down on pro wrestling, basically, because it is scripted. But the athleticism, the things that the pro wrestlers do are a lot of times above and beyond what the physical capacity of the fighters can do. But at the same time, if I had a choice of knowing how to hurt someone, okay, and do it properly, having the perfect technique, while also being able to work with somebody properly, I would take being able to do both of them. Whereas if you're, just a pro wrestler, you kind of miss out on some of the gray area, because I have fought for a long time, I know what it's like to get hurt. I know what hurts, what doesn't. And sometimes people can't identify with that if they haven't been in those situations. So I think that's really where it helps. I can identify when I should be struggling and when I shouldn't, as opposed to somebody who hasn't done the real training.
So you're an MMA fighter, and let's say you wrestle another guy who is an MMA fighter who made that transition to wrestling, and we all know about the strong style. Mm-hmm. You know how it is to get hurt. Do you incorporate that into your match?
Oh, absolutely. For myself, one of the biggest challenges is to get what my vision of professional wrestling is and incorporate it into what everybody else does, because everybody has their own idea of what they want to do or what kind of character they want to be. Me, for myself, what I enjoy watching is something that resembles a fight very closely. It doesn't have to be an MMA fight, it could be a old school Pancrase match. It could be an old UWFI match. It could be any sort of professional wrestling contest where it looks like a struggle. That's kind of what I gravitate to. And there's people who that's not their style at all. That's not what they want to do. They want to be doing flips. They want to be doing a bunch of high spots, hitting a bunch of moves. And that's fine. Everybody has different things that they gravitate towards and that they like. And it's really up to us as performers and professionals to take what we want and kind of mold it into that finished product. And that's the best part about it, but it's also the hardest part.
So you've been having a lot of fun here in Major League Wrestling,
of course, yeah.
Playing your character, having a lot of fun. What can we anticipate here for the remainder of 2018 for Tom Lauder?
I'm coming off a big Battle Riot win in New York a couple months ago for MLW. So I've got a guaranteed title shot in my hands whenever I want it. I'm not quite sure what I'll do with that, when that'll go down. But continue to look for me at the top of the card, because I'm not going anywhere.
You still train. You still train MMA. But did you still get the itch of getting inside the cage one more time? Will you?
Yeah, absolutely. I've been in talks with some companies recently. Unfortunately, I think it was about 2 weeks ago, maybe 3 weeks ago, I was let go by the UFC unceremoniously. And since then, I've been kind of weighing my options, and I have some things on the table. I haven't signed anything yet, but definitely before the end of the year, I'll be back there in that cage fighting somebody. That's for sure.
This is The Roman Show.